Let's get started with protein ligand docking. In this CSDU course, you will learn about proteins, ligands, and functional waters. After the course, you'll be familiar with protein ligand docking and with the basic functionality in our GOLD interface. You will also know how to get started with your docking simulation and how to run a routine protein ligand dock using GOLD. Let's start with some basic definitions. Proteins are large biomolecules and macromolecules that comprise of one or more long chains of amino acids. Ligands are small molecules that bind to the protein and can change the protein function. We will also see some functional waters, and these are usually found in the binding site of a protein and can mediate the interactions between the ligand and the protein. Structures of protein-ligand complexes determined from single crystal X-ray diffraction data provide the clearest snapshot we have of the world of protein structure and function. Such structures have provided invaluable information in the understanding of biochemical processes and have been used extensively in successful structure-based drug design campaigns. Both the CSD and the PDB are valuable resources for protein ligand docking. Here we can see a protein stored in the PDB, and if we look a bit deeper, we can see the ligand highlighted in blue. This links to the small molecule structure of the ligand stored in the CSD under ref code TOBBOB. We can also mine these two databases simultaneously, and one way to do that would be to use our CSD crossminer tool. This performs pharmacophore queries across both databases, as you can see in the animation.
The CSD discovery is the main focus here, and we have GOLD, CrossMiner, Mercury and Python API that help you in various discovery programs. So today we are going to look into the software GOLD. Hermes is our interface for launching most of the tools in CSD discovery. So let us see, today we are going to look into docking. So what is a docking? In very simpler simpler sentence or simpler way to explain, docking is a exercise where we try to bind a ligand or bind a ligand into the receptor. So this docking concept came from the dockyards, where a ship used to dock into the docks. So let us see what GOLD can help us with. So GOLD is a reliable, a very flexible and configurable piece of software that has been successfully used in virtual screening, lead optimization, and identifying the correct binding modes of active molecules. It has been used extensively in academia and industrial research. This particular slide explains that it has been used in medicinal chemistry research, then biochemistry and molecular biology kind of research, where you can look into mechanism of action for a particular interaction of ligand and the receptor. Then in pharmacology and pharmacy, where you can see the effect of the binding of a ligand into a receptor. GOLD has been increasingly used, and it is evident from the publications and the citations that has been mentioned since 1997. There are various different type of exercises or experiments that can be performed using GOLD, such as protein ligand docking, post prediction docking with waters, functional waters. Multiple scoring functions are there available in GOLD for your for our use, and then we can perform ensemble docking, covalent docking, and also of course large scale docking with our cloud and cluster computing. Let us see what we are going to learn today for beginners who are completely new to this, to the concept of molecular docking. We are going to take an example of a kinase inhibitor, and it's docking into the active site of a kinase. So we are going to learn about how to import a protein co-crystal from the protein data bank using GOLD, prepare the protein crystal structure for docking, then perform the molecular docking experiment in GOLD. So we are going to tell you step by step how to set up the docking experiment and then analyze the results obtained from the docking experiment. So here is an overview of what are the various steps in molecular docking using gold. First thing first, target selection. You may have a problem or a question that you wish to solve. So the identification of a target, then you can obtain, import the co-crystallized structure from PDB, from the PDB. The next step would be preparing this particular protein by adding missing hydrogens, checking the protonation states for histidine, glutamine, and the aspargine. Then you may retain or remove the functional waters. If they are functional waters, we would suggest to retain them. If they are non-functional waters, only water of crystallization, then you may remove them. The next step in protein preparation would be extract the ligand and save it as a reference for a future in the same exercise. Then we have to detect or define the binding site in this particular step, where you will define the binding site. We have various options for defining the binding site. So binding site is a portion or a place which is capable of entering into a stabilizing interaction with another molecular entity. You have to select the ligand, or you may select the ligand from your data set or database, or a single ligand. This ligand could be in SDF format, mol or mol2 format. And we have the option of selecting various scoring function. So scoring function, what is a scoring function? Scoring function is a mathematical function used to approximately predict the binding affinity between the two molecules after they have been docked. These two molecules here are the protein and the ligand. We have four different scoring functions: gold score, chem score, Aztec statistical potential, that is ASP, and chem PLP. By default, chem PLP is the scoring function of choice in case of gold. And then we have we will be performing actual docking of this ligand molecule in the active site of our target protein or the protein receptor. Once we run the calculation and once the docking is finished and completed, we will try to analyze. We have to try to analyze the results. Now, the analysis of the results are in two forms, qualitative and quantitative. Qualitatively, we are going to look how the pose is, how that interaction is, where it is binding, how is the overlay with the reference, and so on. In quantitative sense, we are having scores that we are going to look into, as well as the RMSD to the bound ligand. So these are the overall steps that you're going to see today while setting up the docking calculation and performing the analysis of results.